Hi from the 8 on Your Side team. We've heard a lot this summer about flesh-eating bacteria, but a York County woman developed it 2 years ago after a trip to the Jersey Shore.
Medical reporter Susan Shapiro shows us what happened and what you can learn that could protect you and your family.
I love gardening because there's always something to do.
Maureen Horan spends a lot of time in her backyard in Lewisberry.
It's just a beautiful way to spend your time.
But the 61-year-old, who everyone calls Mo, almost didn't live to see things grow and thrive here. Her near-death ordeal began on the last day of a 2010 vacation to the Jersey Shore. She and her husband Dennis had a late lunch. Hers included raw clams.
I knew that there was something wrong when I swallowed the one clam, but it was too late.
This photo at the beach would be the last of Maureen with two legs. She says the one with her legs buried in the sand is ironic. By the next day, Mo was in severe pain. She went to the emergency room, came home, but it only got worse.
I get up, the pain is worse, my toes are black, my arm is red, my leg is red, and my sister-in-law said, I don't know what it is, it's not cellulitis, but you make them admit her.
Mo was eventually flown to Penn State Hershey with the infection spreading rapidly. She was at greater risk because of a liver condition.
It turns out the clam that Mo ingested was contaminated with a bacteria that lives in warm seawater and on raw shellfish. It's called Vibrio vulnificus. It's very rare, but it produces a toxin that kills tissue, a flesh-eating bacteria.
Perfect, thank you.
Orthopedic surgeon Spence Reed was among a team of surgeons who took care of Mo. He amputated her left leg far above the knee to remove the dead tissue and stop the spread of the infection. But doctors did save her left arm. Dr. Reed says his patient beat the odds.
50% of the people who come in like she did die within the first 48 hours of getting the infection. So yeah, she's pretty lucky.
They said it's your leg or your life. And you choose life. Mm-hmm. There's a plug here. And so I plug it into the wall and that charges the leg.
Mo now has a computerized prosthetic known as a sea leg and a large scar on her left arm.
That's the most beautiful scar in the world because I have it.
This was my horse Huckleberry. We called him the Bear.
Mo has always been very active with horseback riding and skiing. She's hoping to do more, including walking her beloved dog Petey.
I'm a bad dog, so hold on.
She's back at Dreher Physical Therapy, learning how to perfect those everyday activities. She walks physical therapist Chad Kettler.
Good, good, good. That was perfect. Good.
And goes over bumpers on the floor.
That was perfect. Good.
Using a prosthetic expends a lot of energy.
It is tough. When I leave here, I'm pretty well wiped out.
Mo was very fortunate. She's got a super positive attitude from the very beginning.
Mo says she now appreciates what she has, not what she doesn't have.
You have to choose your attitude. I can't choose this. But I can choose what I'm going to do in a given day and how I'm going to face the day.
But one thing she will never do on any day is eat raw seafood. Susan Shapiro on Your Side, News 8.
Here are some of the recommendations from the Centers for Disease Control for preventing this disease, especially in patients who have compromised immune systems or underlying liver damage. First of all, do not eat raw oysters or any other raw shellfish. Cook shellfish thoroughly in the shell, boil until the shells open, and continue boiling for 5 more minutes, or steam them until the shells are open, and then continue cooking for 9 more minutes. Do not eat shellfish that do not open during cooking. Avoid cross-contamination of raw seafood with other food.
Wow, really scary.